Radioactive waste from a US atomic bomb test site in the Pacific is in immediate danger of leaking into the ocean, according to the Secretary General of the United Nations.
There is a risk of leaking of radioactive materials that are contained in a kind of coffin in the area. The consequences of nuclear tests have been quite dramatic in relation to health, in relation to the poisoning of waters in some areas.
For the Marshall Islands, we emerged from the colonial period, World War II, and the impacts of nuclear testing conducted more than six decades ago. Only 27 years later, and now facing the consequences of climate change.
Well, here's some background. The nuclear tests were carried out from 1946 to 1958, far away from American territory, on the Marshall Islands in the Pacific. At the time, they were under U.S. administration. The tests included the most powerful detonation of an American hydrogen bomb, which was about 1,000 times bigger than the atomic bomb dropped on the Japanese city of Hiroshima. Many islanders were forcibly evacuated from their property and resettled. And for those who remain, there's been some serious consequences.
The cleanup of the entire atoll was not complete. That is just a portion of the radiation that exists on the atoll. A large amount was dumped straight into the ocean. The entire atoll is contaminated, not simply Runet Dome. And the radiation affects us on a daily basis. And we have many illnesses in our community. Personally, as a mother, it definitely impacts me because when my children get sick, I wonder, is it something more than just a cold or a flu? That worry is constantly there. The islanders have always attempted to bring attention to the fact of what has happened and what continues to happen to Eniwetok, and including petitions to the UN. Court case regarding environmental law, and they are met with silence.
And this perhaps demonstrates what our guest was speaking about clearly. A concrete dome built back in the 70s on one island as a dumping ground for radioactive waste is now badly decayed. It's 40 centimetres thick and more than 100 metres across, covering a 9-metre deep crater. Well, the vast hole was created by the Cactus nuclear weapons test back in 1958. The cover was planned as a temporary fix, but due to cracks may be about to leak radioactive waste. There's been added to by rising sea levels as well. Now, the crater has never been lined, and a US government report also warned of the risk several years previously. A former worker there told us that people are suffering health problems related to the site.
Our mission was to go to the Marshall Islands, and we talk atoll, one of the ones where I believe over 40 atomic bombs were dropped in the 50s, and I think into the 60s, or I will say in the 40s up to the 60s, to clean up everything there with, on the northern islands, which were the most contaminated. They said Eniwetok wasn't contaminated, the main island in itself, but yet it was. They were supposed to take up to anywhere from 6 to 18 inches of soil off, transport it from whatever island they collected onto the island of Runet, place it in one of the bomb craters, the blast craters that were created by an atomic bomb test, and then eventually cap that crater, supposedly to contain it forever. They told us that we would not be exposed to any more radiation than having maybe two or three x-rays a year, which was a total lie. There was no radiation study with us. When certain ones would leave the island, they would have them fill a big jug with urine. Roughly about 8,000 men went there. Many of them have passed away since then. We're losing anywhere from 6 to 7 a year, and that's a very liberal number. We have defects with our children. The government has no compensation for us.